Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, early this morning, the Red Sox Foundation's 9th annual Run to Home Base, presented by New Balance, united 2,600 participants hailing from 37 states who generated more than $2.5 million for the home base program. This walk and run has now raised $25 million to fund pioneering research and care at Massachusetts General Hospital for veterans and families who encounter traumatic brain injury and post-traumatic stress. Along the left field warning track are participants who each raised more than $2,000 today alone, and we thank these committed members for our community for helping our returning veterans resume healthy lives with their families. The home base program began in 2009 with a mission to treat veterans of the wars in Afghanistan and Iraq who were bearing the invisible wounds of war, and to treat their families as well. Last year, the home base program expanded its scope to include treatment of veterans of the war in Vietnam and all service eras. And now, in 2018, the home base program grows again. Today we have a special opportunity to recognize many of the most heroic and inspiring families of our community. In addition to offering our compassion and care for those bearing the invisible wounds of war, we today also remember those who made the ultimate sacrifice, and we expand the home-based program to welcome their families as well. It is therefore our honor to welcome one of the highest-ranking members of the greatest army in the world, a native of Quincy, Massachusetts, who has risen to Vice Chief of Staff for the United States Army. Welcome home, General James C. McConville. Joining the general is the head of the home base program, retired Brigadier General Jack Hammond. The chairman of the Boston Red Sox and the Red Sox Foundation, Tom Werner. The Massachusetts Secretary of Veteran Affairs, Francisco Urena. The executive director of the Red Sox Foundation, Becca Solwasser. And the military product lead of New Balance, CJ Annunciata. And now, we ask you to join us in welcoming hundreds of family members whose loved ones lost their lives as a result of service to our country. Won't you please welcome 548 members of Families of the Fallen. Ladies and gentlemen, so many of these inspiring families have matched their grief with gratitude, their sorrow with strength, and their despair with determination, as they have taken constructive and creative measures to comfort so many others. From volunteering to help veterans to establishing powerful foundations, from building athletic tracks and fields to creating impactful and innovative projects, and from creating enduring memorials to immersing themselves in suicide prevention. Our field is filled with passionate providers of encouragement. These families have mustered the courage to look beyond themselves and look for ways to help others. You have our admiration, our respect, and our gratitude. We welcome you warmly, for you are an inspiration to us all. Among these families, we have selected five, one from each branch of the service, to present our ceremonial first pitch in honor and in memory of every family member. Representing the Army, welcome the father of Specialist John M. Dawson of Whitensville, Massachusetts, an Army medic who died in Afghanistan in 2015 as part of Operation Resolute Support. Please welcome Michael Dawson. From the Navy, we welcome a family from Narragansett, Rhode Island, whose son, Lieutenant Junior Grade Francis L. Toner, was killed in Afghanistan in 2009. Please welcome his father, Frank Toner. From the Air Force, we have a special mother. After her son, Senior Airman Dustin Hadfield, passed away, she founded the Silhouette Project to bring awareness to the fact that 20 veterans of war take their own lives every single day. Won't you please welcome Linda LaJoy? From the Marines, we have another extraordinary mother who has created so much good from so much sadness. After her son, Corporal Brian R. St. Germain of West Warwick, Rhode Island, was killed in Iraq in 2006, she established a foundation to help veterans and student athletes. The creator of the Sergeant Brian R. St. Germain Foundation, won't you please welcome Miss Lynn St. Germain Lund. And now, we welcome the mother of a son who served in both the Army and the Coast Guard. Won't you please welcome the mother of Petty Officer Second Class William Trapnell IV, Miss Suzanne Schaefer. Okay, with baseballs presented by General McConville, let's see your united pitch. Thank you. And now let us rise as one, as the official Marine Corps Color Guard from Marine Barracks, Washington, D.C. presents our colors.
Right, set,
And now, from the 215th Army Band of the Massachusetts National Guard, please welcome Specialist Blair Levitt of Fall River, Massachusetts, who will present the Star Spangled Banner.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight o'er the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming. And the rocket's red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land of the free and the home of the
And now, let us complete this ceremony together as Josh Cantor on the Fenway Park organ leads us all in God Bless America.